Good evening, Philippines. This is Mike Padua, and we are back to our analysis for this New Year's Eve, December 31st, 2021. And I would like to greet you all a happy New Year, happy 2022, and let's hope we have a typhoon-free 2022 without any super typhoon making landfall across the Philippine Islands. Let's hope we don't have these howlers for the New Year. Okay, so it's just a few hours before we strike 12 midnight. And again, Happy New Year to all. I hope and pray you're in good conditions. And this is now our final tropical weather analysis for this year, 2021, as we begin another season of the 2022 of tropical advisories, as well as tropical cyclones that could pose an impending threat to our country within the next 12 months. Okay, so here's now our last for this year, and we will be back next year. That will be on Monday, January 3rd, 2022. This is now our English version of the update. Let's begin. This is the latest graph set, and as you can see, the broad effects of the northeast monsoon continues to affect much of the country, particularly across the Luzon and the Visayas, including Mimaropa, Sulu Archipelago, and the northern portions of Zamboanga Peninsula, Zamboanga del Norte, as well as northern Mindanao and Carga region. So expect some busy wind conditions of 30 to 60 kph. And some cloudy skies and passing rain showers will be expected, except over areas like portions of central and southern Luzon, where some sunshine will be expected. And it will be more frequent with rain and thunderstorms across the Visayas and Carga region because of the tail end of a frontal system, technically known as a shear line. And right here over Mindanao, Davao region. While the rest of Mindanao, including Davao region, we have the effects of the thunderstorm activity due in part of the near equatorial trough. So it's likely to bring rainfall across the southern portions of Mindanao. Right now, no tropical cyclone or LPA developing over the vast area of the Western Pacific. It's all the monsoon and the near equatorial trough, as well as the presently occurring shear line, which has been lingering across the Visayas and along the northern portions of Mindanao, including Carga. So there you go. That's the latest graph set, the last one for 2021. And tomorrow we'll be issuing another update, and on Monday. Here's the fast animation. Let me zoom this. This is from the University of Wisconsin Tropical Cyclone page. There you go. The near equatorial trough has migrated more to the north, and it's affecting for southern portions of Mindanao, while the shear line or the tail end of a frontal system continues to dump some rainfall with thunderstorms across the Visayas, particularly along the eastern sections like Samar and Leyte provinces, and Carga and northern Mindanao will also be affected by this shear line. And if we take a look at the windy.com zoom in satellite animation, this is the infrared version for the past 12 hours or 6 hours. There are some thunderstorms and rain showers across portions of the Visayas, particularly Leyte, northern Cebu, northern Negros, and also some strong thunderstorms across Davao region and Sogsogen, as well as the northern portions of Carga because of the tail end of a frontal system or shear line, while here is more of a convective activity due to the effects of the La Nina phenomenon, and there's a surface trough to the south of that cloudiness, while the rest of the zone will remain dry with some passing light drizzles. So nothing to worry when it comes to flooding it will be more rainier over, it will be more rainy over Visayas and Mindanao. While in the Bicol region, only the areas like Tikau, northern Masbate, and Sorsogon will have some possible showers or thunderstorms brought about by the northeast monsoon. Now, here's the rainfall calculation for the next 3 days until January 2 and 3. Okay, until Monday, we expect more rainfall across eastern Visayas, central Visayas as well, and the Caraga region like Dinagat and Siargao and Sucupgao provinces because of the shoreline. So much rainfall will be expected for the next 3 days, while over the southern part of the Palawan, there will also be some rain showers and thunderstorms brought about by a surface trough here that will develop within the next 3 days. And before we leave you and celebrate the new year, okay, here is the latest wind forecast from the American model, valid for the next 3 days. So today, we still have the northeast monsoon. And if we move forward to Saturday and Sunday, the prevailing monsoon is still there. But on Monday, January 3, it's slowly beginning to weaken. Okay, and just the northeasterly surface wind flow will be expected across the eastern sections of the country, especially Visayas and Bicol region and northeastern Mindanao. So far, that's the forecast. Nothing unusual. Same situation. Just the northeast monsoon and the shoreline that will be expected for the next 3 days until the third day of January 2022. Okay, and if we take a look at the European model, let me get back to this evening. This is the rain forecast. There you go. Here's the shoreline affecting Visayas and northeastern Mindanao or Caraga region. And tomorrow, it will slowly weaken, but will still bring some rains and thunderstorms across Visayas and northeastern Mindanao. On Sunday, January 2nd, more thunderstorms will be expected across Visayas and Mindanao as the shoreline migrates more towards Mindanao. So expect some showers and thunderstorms come Sunday, January 2nd, as well as the southern portions of Palawan because of the convergence of the northeast monsoon with a surface trough over Borneo. And on Monday afternoon, the shoreline is now only concentrated along Mindanao, and some showers will also be expected and thunderstorms across southern Palawan, while the eastern sections of Luzon and Visayas will remain windy because of the northeast monsoon. So expect also some showers and isolated thunderstorms on Monday. Okay, so that's the latest for this New Year's Eve, December 31st. It's already 10:45 p.m. and it's about more than 1 hour and 15 minutes before we celebrate Happy New Year. Okay, celebrate the entrance of 2022. Again, thank you so much for watching our this channel for the past year, 2021. And we will continue to give you more updates for this 2022. Happy New Year to all. I hope and pray more blessings to come to our country, to our fellow men, Filipinos. And also we hope and pray that this COVID-19, which is rapidly rising now in the Philippines, will start to decline as we move into the first quarter of 2022. And also, let's hope that there will be no super typhoons landfalling across the Philippine Islands. From Typhoon 2000, this has been Mike Padua all the time, all the years that we are monitoring this typhoon, and we will return on by next year, okay, Monday, January 3rd. And thank you so much for watching our channel. God bless to all.